Here's the X-75A. Definitely would challenge my skills in bare metal chrome finishes on aircraft. Polished up. Here's the Bell P-59B. Aero Comet, I believe it was the first jet fighter in the free world. Besides the British had their jet fighter too, their jet aircraft that came out. The exhaust for the XB-70. Here's the Bell X-1B. Scott Crossfield flew that one. P-80. Bagel orange inside there. X-3, Douglas Stiletto, X-3. Of course, this is the XF-92A. X5 hanging above. Goblin. XF-85. And they dropped that off the bottom of the B-29. YRF-84F. Another view of the X5. Looks like a drone here. There's no actual cockpit on this one. F-107A. XF-84H. The drone, X-10. North American also. better view of the XB-70 from here. Some of you might recognize the aircraft above. X-29A. X-GAM 63 Rascal. Surface was an air-to-air to surface missile. Of course, they dropped it off. B-47s. Another view of the XB-70. Massive. D-21B drone, which was launched off the SR-71. Still kind of has the shape as an SR-71. Here's the nose gear for the XB-70. Look at the color of the tires for high speed, high temperature flight and landings. The main landing gear for the XB-70. Intake. Republic XF-91. Look how short the wings are on this. Unusual landing gear, tandem style landing gear on a fighter. Bell XV3, rotor blades on top, tilt rotor. You can see the tilt mechanism here. Rotor head and blades, some of the struts. Put skis on this one. Bell helicopter Textron. XB-70 again. SR-71. Actually, this is a YF-12A.